someone would like to.
Do the, by consensus.
I wasn't gonna give you up. So you wanna make that motion?
Sure, I'll make that motion.
Okay, so that trustee Bates is our voting delegate for the ACCT Leadership Congress. And you're gonna second that, Ann? Thank you very much, moving right along. So, any further comments? You wanna get out of it? No, you can't. All right, all those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Opposed, motion carried. Remember, 7.4 has been removed, so that goes straight into board comments. So, we'll start with our student trustee.
Good evening, everyone. Since our last board meeting, I have attended monthly ASMCC Senate meetings and had the opportunity to attend the breast cancer awareness event that was held at ASMCC. I also had the pleasure of meeting with Chancellor Young for our monthly meeting, and I'm also looking forward to volunteering at the 36th Senate Education Council. Thank you.
Uh-oh. Come on, I gotta watch the levity here. I'm already feeling bad, I cut off the president.
Yeah.
Where we're at.
Yeah.
I'm gonna need an escort.
Sorry.
Okay, now we'll move on to trustee Rojas.
Oh, I'm very.
You're up.
I headed the JAPA meeting in Tahoe at the, on the 12th of September.
What makes that?
Is your mic on?
Oh, yeah. I'm sorry. I attended the JAPA meeting, which is the California Joint Power Agency of California, on September the 12th, and then I also attended the finance committee meeting in September. The YCCD special meeting, the fifth anniversary.
Fifth anniversary.
And I wanna say that I wanna thank the faculty and staff at Columbia College. My wife and I were treated royally, and the food was great. And so I had to keep my wallet in my pocket if I did all right. And then I had another finance committee meeting this month, and that's about it.
Okay, thank you, Ann. Don?
Well, I don't have a report unless you wanna hear a report on the indignities that the medical community is gonna visit on you when you get old.
I think we'll save that for a study session. A long study session. Trustee DeMartini.
Thank you. I attended the September special meeting slash study session. That wasn't the topic, but that could be the next one. The County Office of Education has had a dinner for all the district trustees. I attended that with other members sitting up here. Was able to attend the first in Modesto, Elton Celio Latina Intolerant Luncheon. It was a very nice event, I thought well-run for the first time, and YCCD had a table and was able to sit there. Also, I was so impressed with the Brady Wise Family Plaza dedication. I'm stunned and so pleased that we had this huge donation, just really spectacular for this small town. So I just had to be here for that, and I'm so glad that I came. It was very high quality, very tasteful event, and very lovely. I'm so glad that I could be here. Had a policy procedure committee meeting, I've already talked about that, and last night was the League of Women Voters Forum, which is, it's a good event that they hold, like, you know, this little stressful being on the panel. But one thing I want to tell you about is that this Saturday, he had so many things in his report, he didn't go over it, but this Saturday is Wild Planet Day also, and that's in the Great Valley Museum. It's from 10 to 3. The main topic refers to bees, and so they'll have all sorts of activities. If you have any children, grandchildren, or just are interested yourself, it's a really fun event. They have special planetarium shows for $5 a piece, so if you've never been there, go.
Great. Thank you, Ann. Leslie?
Okay, so since we
board retreat meeting on October 14th, and the foundation meetings on August 14th and, I'm sorry, not August 14th. The MJC foundation meetings on August 14th and October 9th. The adjunct orientation on August 23rd, which was great, Steve was there. Institute Day on 24th of August, the board closed session on August 27th. Because we had some compromise that we wanted to work out on one of our policies, we met with Curtis Martin and Ann and Chancellor Young, and that was really a wonderful collegial get-together to try something that people had very strong feelings on both sides, and it was great to be able to reach out and talk to each other. And then a policies and procedures meeting on September 10th and October 8th. The board preview meetings on September 10th and October 8th, public email empowerment luncheons. The annual fall SCOE dinner on September 27th. Came up here for the Brady Wise Family Plaza dedication. That was a beautiful event, beautiful music.
Thank you.
That was so much fun. I felt like I was in the middle of a PBS thing. The League of Women Voters and Civic Engagement Project trustee candidate forum last night. I'm so glad I can be on the with this guy. It was great for us to hear everybody speak. And I'm sure I'm forgetting something that it's been a busy month. Done.
I attended a lot of the same events that have been stated, so I'm going to that study session in particular, which I found very helpful, so thanks staff for putting that together and the presenters that were there. Various meetings on campus, I mean, rest assured that right now all of us are pretty busy with attending meetings, and the finance committee meeting and then the candidates forum last night, and I want to do a shout out to Curtis and Jim for taking the time to be there, because I think it's important that you stay informed and listen to what the board members are coming up and what they have to say. I think it's very important. So thank you both for being there. And with that, I don't have anything. Oh, one small. At the last meeting, I read down in the desk, but I read something from Trustee Lynn Martin, and I think it's important that since this is her area, this is where she's retired from, she still has a lot of friends here and is very connected to this community. I'm going to read this again, so bear with me. So this is from Trustee Lynn Martin, and she desperately wanted to be here, but she's got a family emergency that came up in the last minute, and, you know, for all of us, family is very important. So from Lynn, it says, "It is with mixed feelings that I write to you all today. I had intended to be at both the September and October meetings, but the rapidly declining health and recent loss of my brother-in-law in Houston, Texas, created the need for me to travel there sooner than I had planned, and I'm currently in West Texas as you are listening to this note. I have enjoyed my two terms on the board. I trust I have represented Area 1 competently, as well as the district at large. While I will miss the interactions with fellow board members and district personnel, as well as staff at both colleges, I'm looking forward to full retirement and what that holds. I would like to thank all of the staff of the district, as well as the board, for continually putting students first. In particular, I would like to thank Graciela Molina for not only for her professional skill, but for going above and beyond to make sure that I am sure all board members, have been served far beyond the parameters of her job description. Our mission entails many things, but at the core of the mission is students. YCCD will always be a part of me and blessed to have been a part of the Yosemite Community College District." And with that, our next meeting of the Board of Trustees will be held Wednesday, November 14th, closed session at 3:30, open session at 5:30 at the District Office on Blue Mountain Avenue in Modesto. Thank you all very much.